Hello, and welcome to my first ever director's commentary. I've never done this before, and I've not actually watched that many director's commentaries, which is a bit embarrassing for me to admit. So this is going to be interesting, but this is my Holland 2019 remastered film. It's a remastered, or, well, re-edited version of the first cut I made, and it's probably the film I'm the most proud of, which is why I decided to do director's commentary. It's been about 6 or 7 months since I've released this, and it's still a film that I'm really, really proud of. It's the one I tell and show everyone, the first film I show everyone. I can't remember what unsnapping means, not gonna lie. I think it means like rebuild or something. yeah, this film is very dear to me because I went to Holland basically to forget everything for about a month. At the time I was not doing very well career-wise and just life-wise. So some relatives offered for me to stay with them. So here we are in Ankerveen. A lot of the cuts that are in this compared to the original, some of them are like identical frame by frame with the same music, obviously. But obviously some are different. I have added some archived footage. All of the footage is still archived, which is how I was able to do this. There he is, 2019 Beale. For those of you that don't know, I look quite a lot different now. I do not have that hair. Yeah, that was the room I was staying in. It was like the attic of the relatives I was staying in. I'm holding this microphone, so hopefully it doesn't make a lot of noise.
Also, maybe longer, depending on if
there he is.
Comes up with like filmmaking jobs or stuff like that.
That room is really cozy, but it got very, very, very hot in the hot days in the summer. I was there from the end of August to, I think, it was like midway through August to the end of September, pretty much. It was like the start of my gap year.
To forget everything for 2-3 weeks, maybe longer.
For those of you that haven't seen the original cut, I wouldn't recommend you watch it, to be fair. It's not good. It's not good at all. But it's interesting to see the comparisons, even from the person that actually did it, because they are very similar. This one's just a lot better. I think this was my first day, or second, like, first full day. This entire soundtrack, I crafted quite carefully, because it was all music I was listening to at the time. And when I re-edited the film, I was obviously delving back into old footage, which meant I had to sort of delve back into figuring out what music I was listening to when I needed to add new songs for new scenes. But this is an original song from the first. For those of you that aren't really like aware, this is like a remastered version, and what that basically means is, when I explain to people, is the colour grading is a lot different. It's just a lot better put together than the original. Because I don't even like to call the original, because it's just not good. The editing software I was using at the time was extremely buggy. So when it exported, it didn't come out well. But this version was obviously done on Premiere, which is a lot cleaner. That is all goose poo that was on that. It was pretty gross.
That it connects to this. I mean, that would have been within our financial reach. In hindsight, this of course would not be in our reach. This is more than $1 million.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Loads of the places in Holland, you could do, well, where I was staying specifically, really, a lot of the village was connected by river. So we just canoed everywhere, or kayak, that's kayak, I think. Kayak? Canoe? Is that a canoe? I think that's a canoe. Yeah, you just canoe everywhere. And apparently that river there in the wintertime freezes completely over and people just like ice skate on there, which is crazy.
Oh, Scott, take.
So this is Ron, who let me stay with him, and he was kind of like my mentor for like a month. Really, really, really nice guy.
Here it is.
It is a beautiful place, is Holland. I was actually listening to this song in the car, which is why I chose to edit this with this song. But this was one of the first times where I did like a, I don't know what you would call the edit, but I faded it in to the actual camera audio.
And we also have to get rid of the water from the, even from the Alps.
Yeah.
The rivers, they bring all the melted snow from the Alps here.
Yeah. Wow.
So constantly the water is being managed, and you, but you don't see it.
I did captions for what Ron was saying, not because
that explains
I couldn't understand what he was saying, it's more because the audio was pretty poor.
And the Dutch way of doing politics.
And also what he's saying is really interesting, and I wanted it to sort of
finding consensus.
Yeah.
Not like extreme, but always consensus, trying to make everybody happy. You could say it's weak, but the theory is that
you'll notice some of the shots I've stabilized, a lot of them, but a lot of them I haven't. That's a stabilized shot, for example, but the thing is with stabilizing on Premiere, it is obvious when you've done it, like, that is kind of obvious that it's stabilized, but it looks so much cleaner than the original. But I didn't want to overdo it with the stabilization because it can get a bit jarring after a while. Where is it where it cuts? I think it's in a minute. It cuts to the original audio as we were listening to the song in the car. It's fantastic. This was such a beautiful drive. Some of the planes, they don't even look like they're moving in the sky. There we go. Fantastic song, that. Release by Pearl Jam. God, I look so different. I hated that haircut. I hate it. I can't believe I ever had short hair. And I had it for so long as well. It wasn't like I was young there. 18. No idea what that instrument's called, but that shop was very, very cool. And I can't remember what this town was called, but it was really lovely. We didn't even do a lot that day. Ron just needed to get his keyboard repaired, and that was it. Dutch towns just have a really nice atmosphere to them. They feel very, very European. And they're like, in European films, that's what it feels like. It's very, oh, that beer. The beer, I don't know if you can see there, it's 7.9% beer. A lot of the beer in Holland was 6 or 7%. It's not like Britain. I got smashed. And it's, you didn't get hangovers from it because it was so finely brewed. It was just fantastic. Nice shot, that. Ron's car was so cool. This car, it was one of those old Citroens, I can't remember what you call it. But it ran on gas. I think it was like ethanol. It ran on ethanol as well as petrol. And you could switch in between. So it was quite good on fuel. That trapdoor was a bastard.
Outside with the BBC right now.
I look very 18 there, don't I?
It's all happening.
This is quite a well re-edited scene, really. So the original, I can't remember what song I used. It was a Royal Blood song. But this, I used a lot of Tool, specifically Fear Inoculum, because the album came out when I was over there. So whenever I listen to that album, it does remind me of my trip to Holland, which is why I used a lot of that music in this. I think this was newer.
Guys, yesterday evening I made a giant pan of Moroccan soup. Wow, is there time for that after
the... Yeah, the soundtrack was very, quite hand-picked. I know it wouldn't really seem it if you didn't know, but...
I've got to retreat upstairs because what Ron's filming is quite controversial, kind of. Basically, I'm not allowed to be there while they film it, so I'm going to have some
that
nice
Dutch bread. I don't even know what you'd call it. I think it was like a cross bun. Literally lived off that. I lost quite a lot of weight when I was there as well, which is weird considering I just drank beer and ate bread the whole time.
People, so listen to Slipknot.
It just shows how much shit we eat in this country. Don't know what happened there. That's the only downfall of this film. There's a little bit of grain at that bit. This is a completely added scene, which at first doesn't, on the surface, doesn't really seem like it does a lot, but I feel like it allows the film to breathe a little bit. But also, because it is just like you can just sort of sit and enjoy a journey. But also, see what Ron just said there. I just paused. What Ron just said there was referencing a party that we were going to go to, and then later on in the film we go to that party. So that was quite a nice addition. That wasn't in the original film. This whole bit wasn't in the original film. But it just allows the film to breathe a little bit. I like these moments. I didn't want to just have it every single bit like a music edit, because it gets a bit repetitive. So this was one of the bands Ron was a part of, and this was just like a band practice. One strange thing about Holland is the journeys, they're all, like, whenever you need to go anywhere, you go on a motorway. It's strange. It's not like that in the UK, really. Like, it sort of is, but everywhere is connected by motorway. Can't remember what the original song of this is called, but it's a good song. I actually had a go on those drums. I don't know if anyone knows this, but I used to play the drums quite a lot. In fact, I was in a band for a long time. And a lot of why I was upset around this time in my life was because I used to be in a band and I wasn't anymore. So being able to go on those drums for the first time in a long time was very refreshing. It made me think a lot. Obviously, that's purposely out of focus. I didn't. This is probably one of my favourite edits in the film, I think. So this is when we went to, I think it's Harlem, is the city. So you can tell some of that footage there, stabilised. You can tell it's a little bit jarring, but... See, this whole sequence here, it is all stabilised. You can tell. But the original was so much worse. It's a massive improvement, even though it does look a bit jarring. What a beautiful city that was. I got my first Slipknot merch from there, and I recently sold it on Depop actually just the other day, that short, the shirt that I bought there. That's a beautiful shot. I love that shot. That's one of the best shots I've done. And this one. Fantastic. Like, that was good before I even stabilised it, but after stabilising it, it looks fantastic. This is Stink Fist by Tool, the song. Fantastic song. See, a lot of the music, well, all of this, it was such a reflection of my personality at the time. It's all music I listened to. I still do, but that was very, very, very loud. Like, the microphone peaked, but, like, it doesn't do it justice for how loud that was. This is another one of those sequences that just lets the film breathe. Doesn't, like, nothing really happens, but if you listen very carefully there, you can hear Slipknot in my earphones. This is another one of my favourite sequences, which was such a... It was so thrilling to, like, re-edit this. This is Down in a Hole, Wireless and Chains, Unplugged. Fantastic, fantastic song. This was amazing, this night. So basically the entire village came together and had a party. I can't remember what the reason was. I think it's like a yearly thing. It was wonderful. I got very drunk that night. There's a photo of me somewhere laid out across the jetty. It's quite bittersweet to look at because I know I was very sad at the time, but it was a beautiful evening. See, the song just, it fits so well. That guy was cool. Just sat and smoked cigars. It was quite quiet, but it was a sound blur. Still got that fleece. Yeah, fantastic. Makes me very nostalgic. This was very satisfying to re-edit this bit. So for those of you that haven't seen the original version, for some reason, you know how I said that the music in this film was a reflection of what was going on at the time? I don't know why, but when I first made this film, I edited this sequence to a Lamb of God song called Redneck. It's literally one of the heaviest songs, and I don't know why I edited it to this. It didn't suit at all. This was a much better song choice. And I also prefer this sequence so much more to the original, because remastered the footage again by stabilizing it and adding in more. Very aesthetically pleasing. It was just a really nice evening. And I can't even remember where that was, but we went to this like rave. Well, we didn't actually go in, but there was a rave going on, which is why there was a lot of kids there. See, that stabilized footage is just fantastic. Beautiful shot is that. That's the 10-18 lens that I have doing justice there. I also switched out the song for this sequence. The first one, the first edit was The Pot by Tool, which is one of my favourite songs, but I re-edited it to Fear Inoculum, which fits a lot more, not just because of the difference in song, but I was actually listening to Fear Inoculum all day when I was here, so it makes just so much more sense. For those of you that are interested, by the way, probably not that many, but there is a song list in the... I'll put it in the comments of this, but in the original as well.
Ron dropped me off in Amsterdam this morning. I've been walking around, it's about lunchtime now, I've been walking around basically all day just trying to get a view for the city. I've just been... Now I'm about to head to the red light district.
good bit of Scorpio lore. I already was smoking a little bit at the time, but it was on this day that I actually bought my first pack of cigarettes. Marlboro Greens. Marlboro Greens. Don't smoke anymore, but... See, that shop's pretty jarring.
Observation number one. Everybody here smokes.
It was a strange place, was that? It was beautiful, but strange. It was a mix between this really beautiful scenery of a city. It seemed really modern for some reason, but then it had all of this weird sex stuff. It was just odd, but interesting. This bloke looks like Tom Morello a lot. It's weird. Oh, that's my alarm. Definitely leaving that in the film.
So today we're having a complete heatwave, and I'm trying to write the script for this very film in this room, and I'm utterly melting.
It was extremely hot. I don't know how many degrees, I think it was near 40, but it was ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm happy with it. Layers of reorganization here. Eventually this may be your room next time you come to visit.
So yeah, me and Ron cemented his floor today in the shed.
I was very skinny then. Very skinny. I did lose a lot of weight, but... Ah, another fantastic song by Pearl Jam. This is Garden.
Can I take a photo of you?
This was an added scene, actually, I think. I had to cut it out, the original, if I remember correctly, because of the song I used. I used a Royal Blood song, and a lot of Royal Blood songs are heavily copyrighted. I mean, all of the songs are, but it just banned me from using it. And this song fits so well. I just, oh, it's fantastic. The soundtrack of this film is phenomenal. Something I'm really, really proud of. Because not, like, I know I probably already said this, but not only does it fit so well with the feeling of the film, but it was also all stuff I was listening to at the time. Yeah, I just went to this boat race. It was sort of a race, but it wasn't taken very seriously. And it was all these folk that had boats. And I just joined these two random blokes. These two guys. Can't remember their names, but they were really sound and they barely spoke English. And they had a very good music taste. We were listening to Rage Against the Machine and stuff. I showed them Tool. See, this footage, having been stabilised, it's just fantastic. This wasn't even a stabilised shot, and it looks fantastic. Not a fan of the vignette and the crispiness of that. Which is a bit of a shame, really. It's what lets this cut down. Wasn't one of them things I noticed, I don't think, till too late, but we live and learn. Another Tool song here. Cullen Voices. This was on the way to my work experience. I worked at a company called Kaiser, and I just did some content creation for them, essentially. I made some storyboards for a office showcase video, and I also did some storyboards for the video that they needed as well.
Hello. Sir, I've not actually filmed I've not filmed properly like this in a while.
That was the shirt I bought.
Kind of, well, it's not been actually.
I shouldn't have sold that. I don't know why I did, really.
CV,
And I also
I just didn't really wear it.
An apprenticeship, which is really good. I'm starting to feel as though things are turning around, which is quite good.
Oh, fantastic sequence this. Absolutely fantastic. And this was one of the highlights of the trip. One of the nights, it was a Friday night. We took the canoes. I can't remember the difference, I'm sorry. There's an abandoned shack, basically, in the middle of nowhere, on an island, and it's like, took like half an hour, 40 minutes to canoe out there. And it was one of those like hunters sort of stop places where, you know, they would leave stuff like rations and then you leave something behind. And we stayed there a night and it was just absolutely fantastic. Look at that, it was fantastic. Beautiful song choice as well. I knew as soon as I was there what song I was choosing. Rotten Apple by Alice in Chains.
But you used it during austerity in the Second World War. So you find these everywhere in Africa still and in India.
Ron, love that lamp. That was a very bittersweet night for me as well, because I won't go into detail, but at the time I was going through some pretty hefty emotional stuff with someone, and that night was quite prominent. This was another work experience place I went to. I didn't do a lot there, they just showed me their offices, but they were really nice people. Again, they didn't really speak a lot of English, so I had to just wing a lot of it, but they were nice people. I compared a lot of the office spaces that I viewed and went to when I was over there to like how I would imagine office spaces in like New York and Los Angeles and stuff. It's very, very similar energy. And then we're going home. Tried to mix like a lot of archived footage and footage that you'd already seen in the film with the black and white bits. In the last video that I did, the original cut, it was, if people have not seen it, I'll explain briefly. I kept adding these little sequences in between where I was digging, basically, filmed myself digging. It is very cringe to look back on, but film by Scott Beale. But it was basically trying to symbolise that I was burying the past and it just didn't age very well. Which is why I re-edited it. I didn't mention Anne there as well. Anne was Ron's wife. Are they married? I think they were married. Yeah, they were married. And that's the end of the film. I mean, there's also some special extras here which I need to stay on for, because this is a lot of unseen footage. They're just footage that didn't make the cut.
My area,
this is the first time me talking to a camera in a long time.
I've just set up in my little bungalow.
As you can tell, very awkward. It's very embarrassing to look back on.
I'm turning very weird. Here I am in my place in Amsterdam.
I was very skinny then.
I'm staying with some family, and I thought that I would make a little film.
The whole point of these extras was just to add some.
My first day in Holland, what did I do? Basically, me and Ron
footage that just didn't
on the
make the cut, essentially, but it's still quite funny that I still wanted people to see.
Which is pretty cool. He's already arranged for me to do all sorts, like sailing, seeing live music and stuff like that, so I've got a lot to look forward to. So yeah, it's going to be good. Yeah. Okay,
got it. This shot was in the film, but it needed to be put in the extras because it's just funny to watch back.
Are we off?
Yeah.
Okay. Now.
I don't know why I didn't put that in the original film. I never did. I never saw.
Look at this. This is beautiful.
So we're just leaving this here?
Ron was quite funny.
Oh, wait.
Whenever we went anywhere, he'd never, like, implicitly say what we were doing. He'd just sort of let me, like, absorb what we were doing and figure it out for myself, kind of. Which is a really cool way of behaving. And it explained the complexities of stuff, but not... He only spoke when it meant, and it's one of the things I really took away.
Second proper day, me and Ron are about to go on a road trip to go and get his keyboard repaired, and we're going to go and explore some of the old town, I think. I don't know where this is, but he says we're going to explore some old town, so let's...
There we go. That was listening to Release in the car. Yeah, this is a lot of the footage that's not... So I didn't stabilise this, but this is what was in the film. That beer was so good.
Is that like a genuine thing?
Yeah, that's a joke. So you have to give your name a boat and you call it Bacchus. That means, you know, we are really pissed on the boat.
Tool, listening to Tool in the car. Ron was quite open to my music, which was good. He's clearly like an actual music fan because he wasn't prejudiced to like the fact that I was a metalhead. He was actually very open to it. I don't know if he actually liked it in the end, but he listened to it. Which
video any of it? Because I didn't take my camera because I didn't want to drop it in the sea. I've still got my life jacket on. I didn't get wet or anything. I was expecting to get really wet, but I just didn't, and it was really, really calm. But yeah, tomorrow, what am I doing tomorrow? What am I doing tomorrow? Thursday. Tomorrow the BBC are coming here to Ron's place, and they're filming like a little documentary thing.
I was very skinny then.
I'm not allowed to be.
I know I keep saying that. I'm not fat now or anything, but
it's quite a private.
Maybe it's because I have long hair now. But yeah, you can probably see the definition in my face.
BBC set tomorrow, which is going to be interesting. Hello, cat. Cat's just on the table there. I'm finishing off my CV because I wanted to show them it. If they wanted to see it, it's here. But this is just a final, the most updated version I've got of it. And then after that, we're going to go and see some live music tonight.
So yeah, Ron was getting interviewed for like... It was something in his old work, his old industry that he worked in. And it was a controversy. And the BBC were basically unveiling it, exposing it, which is why I couldn't be there when they filmed it. It was pretty serious.
He showed an interest in the household by asking, how's your soup going on?
She was a nice woman, the interviewer. This is one of the churches. These are my relatives. I can't remember. I think they're cousins. Oh, they're gonna hate me for not knowing. I'm sorry, that is embarrassing, but that car also had hydraulics. Hydraulic suspension, which is just so cool. Yeah, this party was fantastic. The food was unreal as well. I lost a lens cap there though, which was very sad. Had a nice burger there. That was when I confirmed that the dialogue in Pulp Fiction was actually true about mayonnaise. In Holland, in Amsterdam, they put mayonnaise on everything.
And now I'm heading home. So tomorrow I'm going to a film studio, which is going to be pretty mental. So I shall. I'm just filming. I'll be a sec. So yeah. that's what's going on. We're going camping tonight, and yeah, it's going to be mint, so.
Tilly lamb. Have you ever seen them? Scott?
I've not.
This is what you used during austerity in the Second World War. So you find these everywhere in Africa still, and in India.
You know, I haven't seen Ron since this. It makes me really sad. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching this first director's commentary. Hope you found it interesting. I will be doing more. I'm going to do one on Purgatory, my first, well, not first film, but one of the films I made for uni. Thank you very much for watching.